Anyone? No idea? That is strange. Substitute factors with numeric variables. No, you actually have to create factors. So, for instance, you see marital status here, right? You see marital status. So, how will I convert? So, let's say I have marital underscore dummy. I'll use factor function and convert what? I'll convert demo to dollar marital. Yes, and I can check marital dummy 1 to 10. Oh, sorry. Should be square bracket 1 to 10. So now it is saying that levels are divorced, married and single only, but these are not numbers. Okay, so which means that it was already a factor. Okay, it was already a factor. I just created another factor of it, which is not useful for me. Then how do you use it? I have to convert it into numbers. So how do I do it? Any idea? I can create, okay, please go ahead, use mutate and create another column assigning 1, 2, 3. Yes, this is what I was looking out for. Quick, do it. We have learned it. I don't know why you people are waiting. It's very easy. Yes, anyone who is able to create by now? Yes, come on, quick, it doesn't take this much of time. We have already done mutate, right? Amit, you have done it? Okay. Go ahead. What about other people? Okay, fine. So since this is taking a little more time, so this will be your homework. You have to convert it into dummy variable and then plug it in place of duration. Okay, so this is going to be your homework. Convert marital into dummy variable and plug in to model above. Okay, and once you create dummy, then only you can create interaction also. So interaction is nothing but you will multiply any variable, any numeric variable, with the dummy variable. Various ways of doing it, various ways. Okay, it's okay, you can try. So now since we have seen multiple linear regression equation and simple linear regression equation, and dummy is your homework. So now we'll move ahead towards non-linear regression. Okay, so non-linear regression is nothing but there are five different types: polynomial, in which you have power is greater than one; logarithmic, in which you have log involved; then square root, where you have the power is 1 by 2 or power is anything. I mean, it is under root, okay? Like under root 3, under root 4, anything. Then reciprocal, 1 by x, and exponential, e raised to power. The equation will be in e raised to, okay? Yes. Next is cross validation. Now in cross validation, what happens? You take out some part of your data, which is generally 70% of your data, and you create the model on the basis of those 70% data. Okay? And then you take out 30% of data, the rest 30% you test your model. Okay, so you plug in your those 30% into your model and you test it, right? So this is also called as k-fold cross validation method, right? You can do half and half also. So you can create a create a model on 70% and test it on 30%. You can create the otherwise. You can create the model on 30% and test into 70%. Anyways, so this is something which takes you into machine learning. This is what is machine learning. okay, every time the data is automatically training itself and testing itself. Okay, so the machine is learning from more and more observations coming in. Okay, so we don't have much into it, we just had to touch. And then PCA is, PCA and factor analysis are like one layer below the model. Okay, so let's say you have one correlation, okay, or one regression model, but you don't know the actual cause which is causing that relationship. Okay, so PCA is basically when you figure out all the principal components that led to the correlation between the variables. Okay, so if y and x, understand it this way, if y equals to mx plus c, okay, so what was the reason or let's say this in this equation I specified more clearly, so y equals to 2x plus 3, so PCA or FA is involved in finding out the reasons why it was 2. Okay, rather than doing anything else, checking or doing and changing your model, right now you are on this level. This level, what caused it? Okay, so component as 2, value coming as 3. So this is specifically you, or you are solving a very very complex equation and you are not able to arrive to any conclusion, then you use normally PCA. It is very highly used in insurance companies. Okay, why? Because it is taken from the actuarial science. It is a part of actuarial, both of these are actually a part of actuarial science. Okay, so these two are very heavily used in insurance companies. Okay, so PCA is a process of extracting variable from a data set to explain maximum variance in that data set. What led to this occurrence is actually the theme behind PCA. Okay, so let us say you have five different variables, right, and there is one dependent variable and five independent ones. So you will have to find out which variable is causing maximum variance in the data set, okay, or which variable is causing the model to go bad. So you actually extract, you do trial and error multiple times to come up with one variable which was actually disturbing your model, and you, or two variables or three variables, which, and then you can just take them out and rest, your model will be okay. Okay, so it's a trial and iteration process. Like right now we did with age and duration, we can then go ahead with age, duration and something else, and then something else. So it is a multiple iteration and iteration and iteration. So that is PCA. Okay, factor analysis is also used to find out latent variable, the causes, again same thing. Okay, and it is also used for the same thing, to pick up a model or pick out a model which is most relevant, and to throw out or screen out the variables which are disturbing your model. So the both the processes will lead to only one outcome, just the methodology is different. Okay, in one case you consider the p-value, that is principal component analysis. In one case you consider the r-square, that is factor analysis. Okay, so this is all about it. Now one more important thing is to be told in this, and that is multicollinearity, which is not there in the presentation, but it's very important. Multicollinearity. So multicollinearity is that when you are forming a multiple linear regression equation, so m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 and so on and so forth till c. So multicollinearity principle says that there should be a correlation between x1 and y x2 and y, x3 and y, and so on and so forth. Right? But there should not be any internal correlation. Okay? So x1, x2, x3 should not be internally correlated. Okay? So that is multicollinearity. If they are correlated, then it is called multicollinearity. If not, okay. Did not get this? Okay, do you understand what is correlation? Yes. So correlation, the multicollinearity principle says that x1 should not be correlated to x2, should not be correlated to x3. Obviously, the r should be less than 0.6. Okay, r greater than or equal to 0.6 is called as good correlation. So it should be less than 0. Correlation coefficient. Right? So it should not be multicollinear. Okay, the model should not be multicollinear. Okay, so check every time before forming a model or even after forming a model that are these variables correlated to each other. If yes, then remove the variables which are correlated, and if no, then great, go ahead. Okay, so let me conclude all the steps. What you do, first things first, step one, descriptive stats of data to understand who are numeric, who are character, which variables are character, which variables are factors. Okay, step two, check for missing value or outlier. Step three, do linear modeling. Step four, check for p-value and eliminate all variable with p greater than or equal to 0.05. Step, redo linear modeling with new variables, like the new set of variables. Then again, and check p values. Step six, check correlation between all independent variables. Step seven, remove multicollinearity by removing the variables. So let's say x1 and x2 are correlated. So you will first remove x1 and then check the p value and then r square. If it reduces, then that is bad. If this is less than 0.05, okay. But if r square reduces, then that is bad. So then you will remove x2, okay, and then check, because two are correlated. If I remove any one, the correlation is ended. Okay, so now you check for x2, remove x2, check with x1. If r square remains constant or goes up or decreases not that much as in the earlier case, then you will keep x1 and eradicate x2. Okay, remove multicollinearity. This is a multiple iteration process. I'll write here multiple iteration process. This is all a part of PCA. Okay, and then finally check R square of final model. Look for new variables. Improve R square, and then entire thing will start again and again and again. And after maybe 20-30 iteration, you'll have final model. So look for new variables is actually FA. When you try entire thing with new set of variables, so that is factor analysis. Clear, everyone? So you want, you can take the snapshot of this, because this is the step that you are going to follow. Descriptive statistics. Done? Can we move ahead? Okay, now let me ask everyone. So, is it clear to everyone? Abhi, Ahmed, Aki, Amit, Amit Abraham, Aritri, Asha, Bijita, Dipankar, Dyuti, Satish, Jagan, Saurav, Lavanya, right? Yes. And Lavleen, Mahesh, Montelano, Sandeep, Saurav, Shalom, Shubha, Suman, Karthik, Vidya. Okay, Divya. Sorry. Is clear, right? Now, practical, ours, in R, you cannot do it. Okay, all of you will do it right now. One exercise. So, you will do this later on. Now, create a linear model. This is it, you don't have much. Okay, so create a linear model with some other data set. Shall we take? Yes, so let me check which data set we can take. This This is perform simple linear regression. Yeah, this is class data. Great. So it is already actually available inside your R also. Okay. So data class not available. Let me see. Should be available here. Find it. Anyways, we can just import that data set. Right. I'll just quickly import that data set. Gundar, Davos, what is the name that I should give? I'll give it a class LM. I'm giving it a name, class LM. Import. So I have the class LM data now, right? And I'll check head of class underscore LM. This is it. Perfect. So this is my data. Okay. Now I can work on this. So I'll just write model underscore class is LM of, or rather I should attach here. Attach class underscore LM. Now I can write model underscore class LM, and then I want to compare height versus weight, right? So weight tilde right, and I'll just press enter, and then summary of model underscore class. Okay, model underscore class, and after that I'll just press enter and see. So what we'll see one by one, the p value, it is less than 0.05. perfect. And see, this is 3 star, so it is actually equal to 0. Okay, the 3 star means 0, 2 stars means 0.001, 1 star means 0.01, and dot means 0.05. so you have to actually see if it is a 3 star, 2 star, or a single star. If there is a dot or then is there is anything else written, it's useless. Okay, so all these stars means that yes, they can be considered. Okay, they are significant. So yes, I can say that for calculation of weight, height is a significant variable. Okay, so I use this, and then I'll use the values here. Okay, I'll use all the values here in the estimate to create a equation. Okay, and then I'll also check the R square. Since this is not a multiple linear, so it's a simple linear, so I'll check multiple R square. So it is 0.77, very close to 0.8. So I can consider this, but still it needs improvement. So I can say that I can further add new variables and convert it or improve it, right? So how do I do that? I just write another equation here, plus h, yes, and summary, this has not improved very high. It's like earlier also it was like 0.77, now also it is 0.77 only, right? So it is not improving. Parallelly, I'll also check the correlation among the variables. Yes, okay? I'll also check correlation in variables. So how do I do that? CUR, and then I have to check between age, yes, and which other variable should I use? I can use height. Height was there, right? Perfect. I can just write, and this is 0.81. Oh my God. They are also very nicely correlated. So there is a multicollinearity. Okay. Now what I'll do? Now I'll create another model and I'll remove height, because with height I already have. So now I'll keep it with only age and see if the p-value is increasing. No, it has drastically gone down. So that is why the earlier model with only height, this model was my good model. So I'll keep this as my final model. This is what I was talking about. Okay. This is what I was talking about. How do you reiterate and reiterate and reiterate? Got it? Now you people can do it. Sorry, I mean in R, or it's still not very good. Yeah, sure. I'll just make this. Okay. No, it's simple, stat package. There is no package to be used here. No, attach was the data set. Now, the last thing that I can do is find out the predicted values of all the weights on the basis of the model. So how do I do that? I use the predict function. Okay, I use the predict function to do that. So now I can create new class, or rather class underscore predict, and I can say data dot frame, or I can just say class predict, and then I can write predict function model. I'll then write the model which I have made, class and comma, the data on which you want the prediction to be done. Okay, this will be created, and then you can attach it to the existing data. Okay, the predicted values. So how do you attach it to the existing data? Anyone? Yes, how would you attach it to the existing data? If I want this new vector, this is a vector, right? So I want this new vector to be a part of. So how will it to be a part of the original data? How will I do that? How? Quick, write a equation, quick code. Let's see how many of you really remember things. Although it has been my own research that in classes wherein I ask more questions, I get lower rating. And in classes where there is only flow of knowledge, I get better rating. Attach predict underscore class? No. I'm not saying attaching. Attach is for attaching to the R substratum. Who answered this, by the way? Karthik, you did not attend first few sessions of mine. I see, you are understanding what I'm trying to say? I'm trying to say that there is a data. This is a new vector. I want this to be here. So the result should be a bigger data with this part also. Clear now? Quick, should not take this much time. This is the last thing. This is something extra that I've just given. Write the code. Don't give me what has to be done. You have to write the code and give it to me. No one is practicing at home. Mutate, okay, so I'm just writing the code which Amit has sent, mutate, and then class. Are you sure this code works? Not find function mutate because I did not have dplyr is not active. Dplyr. Oh, sorry, I have already written this. Yes. So now, what was it the prediction about? The prediction is about weight, right? The model says that the prediction is about weight. So the actual weight was 1112. It was predicted as per the model as 126. The actual weight was 84. It was predicted to be 77.3. The actual weight was 98. It's predicted to be. Now, mean of weight is 100 point this and mean of Yes, you can. Do you see the mean of weight and the mean of class predict both are equal? I said the model line will always pass through the mean of actual data. So this is the mean of model line. This is the mean of data. So it will always, always pass through the mean of the data. So now I hope practically you understand what I wanted to say then. Okay. And these are all residuals, the differences. Okay. The differences are all residuals. So if you just check which is the largest difference, so the largest difference will be this one, probably 15, or this 18. 18 would be the largest difference. Okay, so these are all residual values. We go to the actual data. This is the max 18. Yes, so this is the largest difference. So these, the difference of these two will be the residual. Okay, so this is your final prediction of your data. Now you could have done one thing as k-fold validation, that you could have made the model on maybe till this much data and then tested the model on this much. Okay, so I can just create some part of data on one side and some part of data on the other side, and then I can do it. How to do that, how to make samples, we will see in our next session, not today, because in next session it is totally dependent on sampling and all that stuff. So you'll learn sampling in your next session. Okay, so that is why I did not do it today. So this marks the end of our lesson 7. Now are all of you clear, happy, satisfied? What? I don't know. I mean, okay, Dyuti is. Great. So next is lesson 8, which is classification. We can do it today, or we can do it in the next session also. Can you explain R square and significance? R is correlation coefficient. R square is coefficient of determination. Now significance is correlation says how much is X correlated to Y. Okay. And R square says that how much of your data points actually agree with your model or lie on your model or are statistically near by your model. Okay, so how many data points agree with your model that yes, this model is good model, and how many of your data points say no, this is a bad model, I do not want to be on this model. Got it, Amit? Not understood? Not satisfactory? Mutate function not working because dplyr is the package that you have to activate. You people are not revising after the session. For me, nothing. It's a basic statistical tool. Just write small MEAN. Attach is just to avoid writing data equals to class underscore LM in the LM statement. Attach is to attach that data set to the R so that R would know that the variables that the guy is referring is from this data set. Otherwise, R will be confused, right? That which is the data set. That is okay. So Shall we start classification today? Or what shall we do? No. See, Saurav is saying to start. Do you want to take a break and then start? It's okay. But we'll start it today. At least I'll just take you through it once. You will automatically say, yes, let's start. Okay. So classification is all about clustering, right? Not very difficult to understand. It's very, very easy, right? So then again, this train data, test data, everything will be here. Okay. So you'll see that train and test thing very clearly over here. Okay. Then there is an algorithm for classification. There are two types, linear and non-linear. Linear is logistic regression or SVM, that is support vector machine. Non-linear is k-nearest neighbor, naive Bayesian, decision tree, random forest, all this. So we'll first see logistic regression. What is logistic regression? Okay. After that, we'll see SVM, that is support vector machine. What it is, how it works like, stuff. Right, then we'll see k nearest neighbors. Then we'll see naive Bayes. Okay, what is a Bayes theorem? And then finally, we'll see decision tree and random forest. Okay, what is information gain? Then we have finally random forest. And this is k-fold cross-validation, which we were talking about earlier today. So maybe we'll not be able to reach till here, maybe we'll be able to reach till here, but this is all. Right? Yes, why not? Just have to click on save button. In R, you have a save button here. Or you can create a new file, or you can just save it. Right? Do you see this save button here? You can just use it. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let me see what is it. Just a second. Next session, we'll be doing clustering and association. So basically, you will have today is our sixth session, right? If I remember it correctly. So next session is yes. Okay, we are on right pace. We can leave it here also if you want. We're on right pace. We don't need to hurry through. Hold on. I can, but then I don't want any manipulation on my NPS part. Right? is going to get hampered either anyway. I'm very rude on that part. If my NPS is going to get hampered, I'll take this session. Thank you, Amit. Okay, in the meantime, I have written to the GTA because he's the person who decides on all these things. Okay. Fine, so by the time I hear his reply, we can discuss just a second. Yes, you can summarize, right? Summary of. Interpretation is clear here. No, it's not clear. Interpretation is. I guess quite clear. R square is good, p values are good, residuals are okay, estimates are good. Done. So you can just, and now you have predicted also, so you don't need to create manually the equation. R has done that also for you. Fine. So now we'll be continuing it for another 20-30 minutes. Okay. But we'll not be going to another chapter. We'll be discussing about the project, the big day thing. Yeah. It's same. GLM will come when you will read about logistic regression. Logistic regression is GLM. Okay, so yes, what you people have decided about the project thing? Which project are you going to do? Okay, Suman has decided over internet. What about other people? Internet, Karthik also. Have you gone through the project or just randomly chosen? Like, I'll just take you through the project. You can take e-commerce, you can take healthcare, you can take internet. those who are taking health care can now start working. Those who are taking health care can now start working. So that will give you a benefit of early submission. All of them are good. All the projects are good. Choose any one that you want to submit. Now, I just wanted one thing, that all of you choose one single for submission. Rest you can do and discuss. Okay, in the last session, we'll anyways discuss. It's e-commerce is more about classification and clustering. Just read through the problem statement. What happened to this? Okay. I'm not able to open only this or any other. Let me just check internet. Maybe that is. Yes, of course. See, why I said to choose one project was that if you all of you choose any one project, then all of you will get a chance to see rest of the other five. If all of you choose different projects, then I'll have to wait till the submission of all of them to discuss. That is why I normally suggest people that choose any one, the entire group, and rest five we can discuss. Okay, but if you choose different, then until unless your projects are not evaluated, okay, or even for that matter submitted, not evaluated, okay, so two people are doing healthcare. So people who are doing healthcare, please start working on it. No, it's not led by me. It's very difficult to find me on weekdays on this portal. Okay, so these are your problem statement for e-com. Okay, the team wants to analyze each variable of data. So first 2-3 questions will be similar, descriptive stats. Okay, then it becomes specific. Like the third question is, find out the probable factors for data set which could affect the exits. Okay, so you're basically doing logistic regression in this case. Okay, and this is basically logistic regression case, e-com. Okay, so you cannot do it right now. Then you have, which one are you choosing? No one is choosing insurance or retail?